Now, the News 8 Storm Team forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
In quite the dreary day in the Susquehanna Valley, looking live over the Capitol from our Harrisburg Skycam. See a low ceiling there. Looks like some fog starting to form. A lot of moisture in the atmosphere, and it's kind of a cool moisture, too. Temperatures are going to be below average today. They're only going to be in the mid-50s for highs, which is technically a little higher than they were yesterday. More scattered showers the rest of the afternoon. There could be a rumble of thunder, mainly south of the turnpike. That's the best potential area for that. No severe weather, though. Scattered showers remaining cool and damp through the evening. Temperatures will be in the low 50s. Then during the overnight hours, we'll drop down into the mid-40s. The showers will end pretty close to midnight, but we stay mostly cloudy, some patchy fog forming just before morning, and then we start to dry it out, and this storm system finally moves along, and it has been in existence for quite a bit, better part of a week, starting out in the West Coast as a major winter storm in the Rockies, and of course moved across the plains, caused all that severe weather, and it's bringing us our shower activity right now when temperatures are in the low 50s just about everywhere. Still 48 degrees in Downingtown, 49 in Lewistown, 53 in York at the current time, and it spawned some strong storms yesterday that formed in the afternoon in western Pennsylvania and also in southern Maryland, and also in Maryland, where the atmosphere was very unstable. We were not unstable, but the storms were able to move over the cool air at the surface anyway. They brought us our rain last night, and that batch moved off to the east, and then another one came in during the early morning hours. That's what we've been dealing with. It's been fairly steady for the most part, but now it's starting to break up a little bit. As we see on the live Super Doppler Radar Network, most of that activity from this morning has now moved well off to the north, and things are getting a bit spottier, and we'll see if the sun can warm some of this area up anyhow and get a few thunderstorms forming later on during the afternoon. Basically, our storm system is still centered over Ohio, and it's very slowly filling in and lifting off to the east. And once that does, we'll start to pull in the drier air and we'll start to get rid of this moisture. So the predictor's showing that stuff moving on out of here. Scattered showers, maybe a thunderstorm later on this afternoon. And then everything starts to really move off to the east very quickly later on during the nighttime hours. There was our clearing on the way for tomorrow, and it stays basically like that, partly sunny skies all the way through Wednesday. Temperatures are going to stay below average, though, for a couple of days yet before we really start to warm it up towards the end of the week. You see, by Thursday into Friday, that's when we're back up to seasonable levels, if not downright warmer by the time we get to Friday. And we've had both yesterday. We had a severe thunderstorm watch that was in effect, and it's that question that never goes the way. What's the difference between a watch and a warning? A watch, well, simply means we're watching for the severe weather to occur. It means conditions are favorable for the severe weather to occur. It issued for large areas. They're in effect for several hours, but on more of a short-term basis, when the severe weather actually starts happening, that's when the warnings come out. They're issued for individual storms or parts of counties, and that's when you have to take action.
Warnings, we'll be bringing a little bit
tips.
More alert
yeah.
to those.
Yeah, warnings means, oh, it's happening, here it comes.
Yep, you bet. All right, thanks, Matt.